Our second selection of this evening is written by Greg Gilpin. He writes a lot for high school choirs and middle school choirs. This is a slower song. It's called I See a Star. We're going to close our portion of the evening with a song that you're going to hear played from a couple of the different songs in the concert band. This is based on the Ukrainian bell carol, or Carol of the Bells, as we know it as, and this is called Ring Silver Bells.
Thank you. stands in front of us. Bring in 8 chairs in front of us. Stage crew, I need one music stand over here.
I think we're back. Hey, there we go. All right, good evening. Welcome back. This is our junior concert band on stage in front of you. These are students in grade 9 and grade 10. We're going to begin this evening with a composition called And Bless Us, Everyone. It's a Christmas medley, arranged by William Owens. It's going to feature three traditional carols, God Rest Ye Merry Gentlemen, Steal, 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 and Go Tell It on the Mountain. Just out of curiosity, is this mic coming through the house speakers at all?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. I can't tell up here, so I just wanted to check. The second piece we have for you is a piece written by Gustav Holst. It's called In the Bleak Midwinter, and it was arranged for concert band by Robert W. Smith. And I just want to read a little bit here. Oh, it's really hot now. We don't want it too hot in the live stream. So this was originally composed in 1908. And is the second movement of the Holst Winter Suite, a work that was inspired by the creation of a three-movement tribute to Holst. Miss Alta Sue Hawkins was a retired band director and suggested the title to Robert W. Smith as a possible symphonic setting. Unfortunately, she passed away before the work was complete. In remembrance of Miss Hawkins, Mr. Smith rescored the entire publication. Following an opening fanfare, statement of the melody is first stated by solo clarinet. The clarinet solo represents Miss Hawkins, a clarinet player and teacher. The clarinet is joined by French horn, euphonium, and a second French horn, representing Miss Hawkins and each of her three children on their chosen instruments. There's a woodwind choir followed by a full ensemble that state the beautiful melody one final time and is wrapped up with a traditional folk melody, Shenandoah. And this was written by Robert W. Smith in memory of Miss Hawkins and her three children.
Thank you.
for our closing piece, a Christmas tale, Beware the Krampus. In some European Christmas traditions, Santa Claus does not work alone. He travels with the Krampus. Have you guys heard this story? Anybody out there heard the Krampus? No? Okay. Pay attention. Okay. The Krampus is a Christmas devil who doles out punishment to the bad boys and girls on Christmas Eve. A Christmas tale is going to feature numerous Christmas carols as you've never heard them before. These are all going to be interwoven with a poem written by the composer called Beware the Krampus. I'm excited tonight to invite to the stage Mr. Florizone to narrate the poem for us this evening and hope you enjoy A Christmas Tale.
Check one. Hello.
It's on, but...
Really?
Yeah.
I don't hear myself. It's okay.
A project.
Use your teaching voice.
Oh, there we go.
If you've been good, child, on Christmas you'll find the toys and the gifts that Saint Nick left behind. But if you've been bad, child, Saint Nick won't be there. Instead comes Krampus, and then, child, beware. On Christmas Eve, Krampus will come to your room with his horns and his switch and his eyes full of doom. He'll click his black claws and he'll comb his dark mane and he'll laugh and he'll scream as he rattles his chains. But if you've been awful, child, most terribly bad, then worse will await you, young lasses and lads. He'll grab you and stuff you deep down in his sack. He'll take you away, and you'll never come back. Thank you.
If you've been good, child, on Christmas you'll find the presents and gifts that Saint Nick left behind. But if you've been bad, child, Saint Nick won't be there. Instead comes the Krampus, and then, child, beware!
We're good. All right, I think we're totally good. Where's my... Hey, there we go. We're going to close out this evening with... Ooh, that's really hot now. With our Senior Wind Ensemble. We're going to start off with It's the Most Wonderful Time of the Year, originally written and recorded in 1963 and made most popular by Staples in July. You know those commercials? Yeah? Anybody? Hey, if they come out before my birthday, I get really grumpy. My birthday's the end of July. And if they come out, you know which ones I'm talking about, Mr. Bernard, yeah? Hey? Hey? This is a way better version. This is It's the Most Wonderful Time of the Year. Second selection for you this evening is Whisper to Their Souls. It was written in memory of Thomas S. Fowler and commissioned by his son, Dr. Alan Fowler. Thomas S. Fowler was, he passed away, on Christmas Eve 2004, just a few hours after completing his yearly service as the Santa Claus at a mall in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Pops, as he will ever be remembered, grew a long white beard shortly after the birth of his third granddaughter and set out to find a job as Santa Claus. He and his son, Alan, sat and talked about how much fun he would have and how much they would miss each other while they were apart. In the weeks following Thanksgiving 2004, the elder Mr. Fowler's health took a turn for the worst. And while he knew he needed to get to the doctor, he wanted to finish his gig as Mr. Claus and get home to his family. Mr. Fowler's wife flew to Pittsburgh on Christmas Eve so she could ride home with her husband the next day. And just 2 hours before he picked her up at the airport, Thomas Fowler suffered a severe heart attack from which he would never to recover. Whisper to Their Souls is based on the traditional Christmas carol Greensleeves and was first premiered December 1st, 2005 at Eastside High School. We're going to close our portion of the night with Christmas Lights by Curtis Sharp. And it's influenced by the classical-infused sort of rock orchestras, Mannheim Steamroller, Trans-Siberian Orchestra. They've all become super popular, especially with the growth of social media. Christmas Lights, we're going to make use of a lot of non-traditional concert band instruments. We've got piano, we've got drum set, we've got electric bass, we've got electric guitar. And it's based around the Ukrainian bell carol, but it also features some lesser-known carols, including an English carol, the Coventry Carol, Toyland, Good Christian Men Rejoice, and The Holly and the Ivy. We hope you enjoy. Thank you. not time to go quite yet. The reason we're all here. We are going to invite everybody who has performed so far up to the stage. Juniors, there are lots of chairs and stands in the wings. Seniors, we're going to spread out and make some room. Okay, most of the chairs and stands are on that side. Well, they're quietly getting up here. I'd like to take a moment just to thank a whole bunch of people. First of all, I want to thank all my admin team and the staff here at GW Graham who are always, always, always so supportive of the music program and supportive of the arts. And I consider myself so lucky to work at this high school. Parents, I want to thank you, grandparents, family members, aunts and uncles, neighbors, friends, anybody who came out tonight. Thank you for coming out, for supporting us, for supporting these children. And I did want to let you know, since I've had a lot of questions, all the donations that we collect at our concert go directly towards our music department's scholarship and bursary fund. So we have three scholarships we like to award or contribute to. One is our music department scholarship, one is the Chilliwack Music Educators Bursary, and one that we contribute to is the Emily Jensen Memorial Fund. I want to thank the students that are all on stage with me this evening for sharing their efforts and their hard work and all that with you guys. Choir kids, we're going to come right along down here the front, right? Down here. And lastly but not least, I want to thank Mr. Foltz and his live streaming crew. I know Mr. Foltz isn't here tonight, but there's a fantastic crew of broadcasters that are enabling us to not only do this live, but share it with people across the globe and anybody who's watching. So this is the moment you've all been waiting for. I'm sure your kids have warned you. If they haven't, here we go. It's audience participation time. In the middle of your program are some words to some Christmas carols, and we're going to have a sing-along. And I don't know how this is going to work because I've never done this before, but we're going to give it our best go once we get set up. Does this mean it's joke time? I told them if they took too long, I would start telling bad band teacher slash dad jokes. Okay. Good, okay. Okay, shh, don't spoil this one. Okay. How do you fix a broken tuba? With a tuba glue. Drummer, where's my drummer? Hey, there we go. Good. Uh-oh, more joke saxophones? What do you call a cow with two legs? Lean beef. Thank you. Good, good, hold on. There's more. What do you call a cow with no legs? Ground beef, yeah, good. Good, good. Here we go, here we go. This is where it gets good. What do you call a dog with no legs? Nothing, it's not gonna come anyways.
This is good, eh?
This is the most fun I've ever had at a concert. Here we go. How many conductors does it take to screw in a light bulb? I'm a little nervous about this one. If at some point during this song someone could get a photo of this entire group and send it to me later, that would be greatly appreciated.
Thank you.
thank you so much for coming out this evening. We hope you have a safe and happy holidays. Take care, everybody.